Hey guys, happy Friday. Listen, this is not a typical video. This is a bonus video that I decided to do because yesterday I was scrolling through Twitter looking for anything that, you know, would stick out to me that maybe I could, you know, get some information about, maybe any stories that were going on, just anything like that. And I come across this TikTok that Elijah Schaefer shared. So I clicked on it. And it got me thinking. And I've seen videos like this before. But I just never really thought about it. I just thought, my God, these people are deranged. I don't know what has happened to, you know, this part of our population that they have lost it as much as they have. They have joined the cult of the virus and mask wearing and, you know, getting the jab. They've joined this cult. It's like a religion to them. And they make these videos. They actually sit down and they brainstorm this. They write it. They record it. And then they release it. And throughout that entire process, did nobody tell them, this is stupid, this is dumb, you guys, you really shouldn't release this, you're going to make yourselves look really dumb? No one told them that. Someone literally watched them make these videos and said, yep, that looks good, send it off, let's go. I feel sorry for people who do this kind of stuff because they're making themselves look so ridiculous with no thought of their future selves. How is this going to impact their reputation in the future? They just release it and let it go. So what am I talking about? What kind of videos? Song parodies to encourage people to go get the jab. And that's what's crazy to me, is that this is such a wonderful vaccine. It's so safe. Really, we promise you that not only do we have to bribe you with million-dollar lotteries in Ohio, or concert tickets, or sporting events tickets, or, you know, just whatever, free food, you know, that's going to make you fat and inevitably cause you to be more likely to get sick and die early. Burgers, fries, Krispy Kreme donuts. So not only is it so safe and so wonderful that we have to do all that, but we have to make what they, I think that they believe they are fun and cool songs. They're not. But I think they believe that they are fun and cool songs to encourage people to go get this. And they're not cool. They are not fun. They're so dumb. And I die of embarrassment just watching in the privacy of my own home. I die of embarrassment. It is so embarrassing. So I just wanted to watch a few of them and just share. And maybe you can laugh along. And I hope you don't die of embarrassment too. But I'm telling you, here is your caution. You may also die of embarrassment. So you cannot get on to me if that happens to you as well. I forewarned you. Okay, so this first video, it's a Stayin' Alive parody. And the reason I skipped from the beginning to this point that I'm about to show you, I just want you to watch it. And then I want you to see if you see what I see. And then I'll tell you.
Staying alive, staying alive. Protect the cold, shake it to painful head, take it twist.
Okay, I don't know if you saw what I saw, but that scene with the parents and their child, that child looked so terrified or mortified, maybe both. And I'm just like, at first, I thought that they were going to pretend give it to the child. And I thought, yeah, that is crazy. But I mean, the way she's just like buried in her dad's arm, like, my parents are weird. Please get me out of here. How embarrassing. Can you imagine when she's what, 15, 16, her friends find this video and they just make fun of her to no end because her parents were weird? I don't know. People are nuts. Okay. Also got another one.
Together, we can overcome. Yeah, wanna help you.
Good job, Chukang.
Hey, thank you, director. I go first, huh?
Wait, please, we need your help.
Okay, let's go! Some say la, some say la. Guess who's back? It's Uncle Hua.
And me, Rosie!
Everybody, it's time to vaccinate. Faster, Lola! No time to waste.
But you are easy, confirm safe.
Aya, Rosie, come on, be brave. The vaccine is not anyhow wet. And against COVID, it will protect. Singapore, don't wait and see. Better get your shot. Steady, boom, BP.
Can take? I'm not sure, leh. I'm quite afraid.
Chronic illnesses, mild allergies. All this can take. There you see. If not sure, relax. Don't panic. Ask your doctor at the clinic. It's safe for most, including elderly. Cause the government got checked properly. Singapore, don't wait and see. Better get your shot. Steady boom BP.
Numbers now so low. Why take now? Just take it slow.
Ha! Low cases isn't no cases. Don't sabo and throw our faces. The vaccine don't just protect us. It lessens the spread. Now that's the plus. We don't catch it means we don't spread it like that. Then can keep people safe. Got it? Singapore, don't wait and see.
Okay. I can't take it. Oh my gosh. Okay. So what I've also noticed is that, oh, no, go away. What I've also noticed is that this isn't just people on the internet making up songs and just putting them on the internet. These are literally countries that are doing this, governments. It's so weird that the governments are getting involved in this because, I mean, it makes your government look like, useless. This one that here that I'm about to pull up, it's called Mr. Biden, Bring My Vaccine. It's a Randy Rainbow song parody. I don't know who that is. I just happened to come across it, and I thought the opening bit, I laughed. It was funny. But the song was horrible. So, The Randy Rainbow Show, executive producer Randy Rainbow, starring Randy Rainbow, written, directed, and edited by Randy Rainbow. Why didn't you just say Randy Rainbow did all of these things? Why did you have to do it in separate ones? Okay, here we go.
Could you maybe at some point just like curse or say something completely Looney Tunes or offensive? The other guy used to do that, and it just made this whole thing a little funnier. I'm just trying to work with you here.
We're live in 3, 2.
Welcome back. I'm joined now by a man some people believe is the President of the United States, Joseph Robinette Biden. Robinette?
Yes.
Don't even have to write a joke about that. Joe, can I call you Joe?
No.
Girl, we have a lot to talk about.
A lot to talk about.
As the coronavirus continues to wreak havoc, Americans are getting restless and frustrated, if you know what I mean.
One of the disappointments when we came into office is the circumstance relating to how the administration was
Yeah,
handling COVID
that's exactly
was
how
even
I
more
feel
dire
anytime
than
I
they
hear
thought.
him
We
talk.
thought they indicated there was a lot more vaccine available, and it didn't turn out to be the case.
Because we're doing so much testing.
Huh? Oh. Excuse me, I think I must have fallen a.
You don't ask Biden tough questions.
Ha! Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm still having flashbacks.
So we're pushing as hard as we can to get more vaccine manufactured.
You now say we'll have enough supply for every adult to be vaccinated by May. Does this mean I can go to Cancun for spring break with Ted Cruz and the gals?
Well, I didn't say that.
Mr. Biden, bring my vaccine. Keep me protected from COVID-19.
I can't.
To how I'm Moderna. Fix of that magic Pfizer or Moderna.
It's so weird. I want to know why he always looks shocked. His eyes, Randy Rainbow, his eyes are always like so bright, like deer in headlights. It's weird. Anyway, it wasn't really particularly about the song as much as it was just the first bit, because I laughed and I thought it was funny. I think it's funny to think that journalists have nightmares and they dream that they're interviewing Trump again rather than Biden. I think that's funny. It means they're having mental breakdowns all the time. So, I don't know. It's weird. I find this just... I don't know what happened, that this is such a popular thing now to write. I know writing parodies is popular. People do that. But about one subject like this, when is the last time anybody wrote a parody about any other vaccine? I don't think there is any. And if I'm wrong, please correct me. From my knowledge, no one's ever written a parody about getting vaccinated. No one's written parodies about a pandemic. We had a pretty bad case, you know, back when Obama was in office, H1N1. Where were the parodies for that? There were none. So it's so weird that I'm not saying that this virus isn't real and that it doesn't affect people. I know that it does. But the government and the media has blown it so out of proportion that there are there's full songs and music videos and, what was the other thing I was talking about? About not just the vaccine, but the virus in and of itself, about mask wearing. And it's just like, it's so weird. I feel like I'm living in the Twilight Zone sometimes. Okay, so this one is from India. Now, this is the Indian government had this video done to encourage getting vaccines.
Oh my God!
I like the beat, though.
के मारो कोई ना बच के जाने पाए डॉक्टरों को समझा दो ये टीके से कोई रहना जाए इसके सारे डोज लगाना सबको यह मैसेज जाए जिसे नहीं वैक्सीन लगाना प्यार से उसको भी समझाएं
कुछ दिनों की बात है फिर अच्छे दिन का राज है वैक्सीन अपनी खास है फिर डरने की क्या बात है वैक्सीन अपनी खास है फिर डरने की क्या बात है ये तो बस शुरुआत है ये तो बस शुरुआत है
अभी तो वैक्सीन शुरू हुई है अरे अभी तो वैक्सीन शुरू हुई है
अरे अभी तो वैक्सीन शुरू हुई है
बाद में ना कहना भाई हम दे दें ये
Okay, so here's the video for India. And what's crazy to me is that all of the governments globally are doing stuff like this to encourage vaccination. And it's like a global effort of all of the governments combined. So for people who don't believe it's safe or who are just not sure, does it not strike you as odd that all governments are working in tandem to get people to get vaccinated? Governments that don't get along, but they're all doing the same thing. They're all using the same tactics. That, to me, is a big red flag. So, I know these videos can be funny and we can laugh at them, but let the wrong person watch it that's easily brainwashed, or kids for that matter, because this is, you know, a song and they can dance to it and it's fun, which I don't know why they use songs and music videos to reach the masses, because as adults, you would think that we're smarter than that, but I guess we're not. Millennials, I am sometimes ashamed to say that I am a part of the millennial generation. I think they're lazy. I think they're entitled. I think they're just, they have their priorities wrong. They would care more about their phone getting broken than if their car broke down. And yes, I read that. It was a poll and they asked a bunch of millennials which would be worse. And I'm like, why is your phone? You need a car to get from point A to point B. Your phone can wait. You could just get a really cheap one for the time being. It's weird. And then you have the Gen Zers coming up that are on the computer all the time. TikTok. TikTok is really bad for these younger kids because it's, there's just no monitoring of what kind of stuff is going on TikTok. It's crazy. If they would put some effort into controlling and monitoring TikTok as they do into Twitter and Facebook, I was just restricted. My activities on Facebook were restricted. I can't share any links, not just mine for my YouTube channel or my podcast, any link, no matter what link it is. And then somebody invited me to join a Facebook group and I clicked join and I was told that I was restricted from joining Facebook groups until June 23rd because I posted something that went against the community standard guidelines. And I'm like, wait a minute, I didn't even get a warning that I did something wrong. They just automatically restricted me. It's getting ridiculous. I'm going to have to find new ways to promote. This one here is the, I don't know how to say that, Nalovu Youth Choir, Jabba Jabba, get the vaccine. What's really sad about this one, number one, I don't know how old these people are. I think they're kids, like teenagers, obviously. But they are so good at what they do, the singing and the dancing. They are really good. And to take that talent and waste it on something like this, it's sad. But I liked it. I didn't like what they're doing. I don't like what they're promoting. But I did enjoy listening to them and watching them. Watched the whole thing because it wasn't that long, and I just enjoyed it. It's fun to watch them. You can really get into it, but just a waste of their talent. So Cuomo, now I don't know if it's Chris or Andrew. Is that right? Chris Cuomo, Andrew Cuomo. Yeah, I think. Anyway, I don't know who released it. But it's from It's on CNN. It doesn't matter. It's probably the governor. Anyway, here is this one.
The vaccine. You got the vaccine. They got the vaccine. We got the vaccine. We can get back to normal. Let me inform you. Let's all get the vaccine. It's about community immunity. I'm talking unity for you and me. If Doc says it's good, then trust me, it's good. Now let's all get the vaccine.
I'm the king of rock.
There is none higher. DMC, I will inspire. Time for us to trust and not debate. The vaccine, believe it's safe to take. 9 out of 10 people won't get sick. That's 90% effective and legit. This COVID thing is real and it will find you. It's killing our people. Let me remind you. Back in the days, there was polio, smallpox. Back in the days, measles and mumps, man. Back in the days, but because of the vaccines, none of those days. Vaccines, they work to trigger immunity. 2 shots, we got antibody security. We gotta act now. No need to wait. Get your vaccine before it's too late. For real.
Okay. First of all, vaccines for like polio, measles, mumps, things like that. Those weren't research created and tested, quote unquote, in 8 months. Those were years in the making. And when people started getting these vaccines, you didn't start hearing a lot of stories about people that are going through things. And some people died shortly after. Some women that got it miscarried. Some women who were, you know, breastfeeding their babies, they passed something on through their milk to their children and they died. I have a video, and one of these days, maybe I'll pull it up, with medical documents showing that this stuff is true. This stuff really did happen. This is why people are very hesitant of taking it. The only people you see talking about it, number one, can you trust that they really got it, or are they lying to you? When you see them get it on TV, is that really the vaccine in there or not? You don't know. So you can't even trust your local leaders that they're also getting it, telling you that it's safe. You can't trust any of that. Camera tricks, whatever. But then everything else that's coming out about it, and the fact that it was created in 8 months, and the fact that it's emergency use only, and it's not been fully researched and tested, there's so much uncertainty to it. That the only people that are taking it are the brainwashed, liberal, hypocritic, virtue signalers. Those are the only people getting them. Your pansexuals and some of your LGBTQ community people that like to get on TikTok and scream at all of us conservatives. Tell us that we're fatphobic and all of that. Those are the types of people that are getting it. And they can keep getting it if they want to. I won't stop them. This is the video that I saw yesterday that started this whole thing. It's called Vaccinate. And it's by San Francisco Gay Men's Choir. Yeah. That's a thing. Okay. Shorter shorts than I wear.
Vaccinate, vaccinate, get rid of COVID.
here's my problem with this video. They should have rehearsed that way more than when they took this video. Because they were off key. They weren't in sync. They were doing different moves while they're standing there singing. That was the most uncoordinated choir performance I think I've ever seen. It was, that's crazy. But that's what kicked this off for me to start looking for all of these songs to go get vaccinated. But to me, the most egregious that I have found has ruined, well, no, it almost ruined one of my most favorite musicals. I love the musical, and to take a song from it and change up the lyrics and sing like you think you can sing like this woman, Julie Andrews, please don't ever do that again. I'm so disappointed that someone ruined this song.
Oh, help.
Okay, I can't. Ruined such a wonderful song. One of the best musicals I've ever seen. And you ruined it. And also, you're not mindless. You are a drone marching to the same beat of every other person that is trying to virtue signal about getting vaccinated. That's mindless. And the thing that really irritates me is they're like, well, everybody, the more people that get it, then the safer we're going to be. And so everybody needs to get it or the virus isn't going to go away. Duh, get the vaccine. It's called herd immunity. But all of time that it was identified and defined, herd immunity, until like 5 minutes ago, herd immunity meant that when a certain percent of the population contracted a virus, then that would be herd immunity. And it would stop spreading and the cases would go down. Herd immunity has, herd immunity has never meant more people getting vaccinated than not. It's never meant that. And that's really one thing that the left does a lot and they're very good at is redefining words. And they do it so, they're so good at it that most people don't even realize that these words are being redefined or replaced and they're being switched around and you don't catch it. Like, the easiest example I can think of is equality and equity. Those are not interchangeable, yet the Democrats use them interchangeably. Equality means the same, having access to the same opportunities. So we're all equal under the law. We all have the same opportunity to, you know, go to school, graduate, go to college, get a good job, build our dreams, make a good lives for ourselves, get married, have kids. We all have those same opportunities, whatever. Equity is everybody has the same outcome. So no matter where you start, high up here or way down here, your parents are rich or your parents had no money, but we are all going to end up at the same spot in life. And to achieve equity, so first of all, you can't have both. You can't have equality and equity, one or the other. To achieve equity, you have to take from somebody else to give to somebody else. That's how you achieve equity. And you don't raise people up to achieve equity. You pull everybody down to the same level to achieve it. So when they start saying, you know, equity, equity, just realize they're talking about something completely different than equality and you should never support it or back it. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. It was nice to have a laugh. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, subscribe, and you can comment, send me an email, gottasaysomething21@gmail.com. I think it's on there. And also, join my my subreddit. Just gotta say something. Be really great to build up that community. Don't even worry about Facebook right now because I'm restricted and I can't do much. So I hope you have a really good day. And I'm going to leave you with one last video. Have a good day. God bless.
Born free as the wind blows, as free as the grass grows, born free to follow your heart. Live free and beauty surrounds you. The world still astounds you each time you look at a star.